The International Criminal Court has replaced the principle of innocent till proven guilty with guilty till proven innocent. That's the view of Sudan ambassador to South Africa. The ICC has been criticized for targeting African heads of state.
Several strange cases from ICC. Prosecutor versus Lubanga, the very first prosecution witness confessed right in the courtroom, which is, I specifically stress, right in the courtroom during the open session that he gave a false testimony. And it's the prosecution that taught him to do that. Nothing was done by court. And I'm not sure that the mass media reported that event. Prosecutor versus Uhuru Kenyatta and others. In March 2015, the case was dismissed. It was quite a positive response on this dismissal of the case. But there is one disturbing thing in this dismissal, that it was dismissed after 3 years of proceedings. And another disturbing thing is the explanation why the case was dismissed. The court said, because there is no witnesses. So I enumerate only three questions. First, how the indictment was made when there was no witnesses? It's a question for prosecution. Second, how the court confirmed the charges? Because the court confirmed the charges. And third, how the case proceeded for 3 years without witnesses?
The court is currently dealing with cases from 8 African countries, and it has issued a warrant of arrest for Sudanese President Omar al-Bashir.
Talking about al-Bashir case, we are talking about the serious attempt to destroy the state sovereignty. That's why South Africa and all other states should make a collective effort first to defend international law, progressive international law, and to resist for the attempt to create a new repressive global law.
South Africa came under fire for allowing President Omar al-Bashir to leave South Africa, even though the ICC had issued a warrant of arrest for him. Al-Bashir was in the country attending the AU summit in Johannesburg.
The head of the state is a personification of the state, and he symbolizes the sovereignty of the state. When Professor Alex spoke about what is targeted is not Bashir, it is not Uhuru Kenyatta, it is Kenya and Sudan. This is now the target is there. And the immunities of heads of state is well established in international law. An international court of justice has in many cases established that fact.
President al-Bashir is expected to attend the United Nations General Assembly in New York next month. Sophie Mukwena, SABC News, Johannesburg.